What's up YouTube? It's Curlisa Victoria back with another video. If you guys are new to my channel, thanks for tuning in. If you've already been subscribed, thanks for coming back. So in this video, I'm just gonna get straight to the point, let you guys know what I'm doing for gains and fat loss. So if you're new to my channel, thanks for tuning in. If you've already been subscribed, thank you so much for coming back. So first things first, let's talk about these gains. Let's talk about my struggle area, and let's just talk about starting weight, current weight, goal weight. So basically my starting weight, let's just say at one point I seen 179, 180 on the scale. It was at the time I had first become vegan, and basically I think I began to gravitate to more carbs that I wasn't usually gravitating to because of the lack of meat, dairy, and things like that. So when I first became plant-based, I went pescatarian, which is basically only eating seafood and like chicken. And eventually I realized that I wasn't even eating much of that. If anything, it was more seafood than it was like anything else. So it was seafood and salmon and things like that. So I eventually got to a place where I was like, even that's not making me feel 100% sometimes. So I literally cold turkeyed and just went vegan, just because I was sick of feeling sick. And then with seafood, you don't want to eat too much of that. That mercury from the sea and all of that, you don't want that literally building up in your body and it becoming like a problem. So I decided to get rid of the actual seafood portion, the pescatarian portion, and to go completely vegan. During that plant-based experience from the beginning until now, which has been about 2 years and some change, I literally experienced like probably a 30-40 pound weight gain. Not overnight, of course, but I just realized that even some days when I didn't feel like I was eating a lot, I think that it still was what I was eating more so than the amount I was eating, because I felt like how could one gain this type of weight when their portions are not as big as, you know, like what they were eating previously, or if the portion control did not change. And then I started to realize, well, what are you eating? And that's when I started to see that I would gravitate to certain foods that might be a little bit more in carbs and things like that. And obviously, that's not going to be the way to go on a plant-based lifestyle. So you can have carbs, you can, but you just gotta, it's almost like now you have a different type of focus when you're trying to lose weight, maintain, gain, all of that, because now there's no presence of meat or dairy. So now you have to figure out, how do I actually survive but eat healthy? And I know fruits and vegetables are the thing of the plant-based life, but you're like, okay, when I don't want to eat that, or I do want to eat that, but I want something else, what could I have? So for me, I started the 179, 180, and I've always had been like 125, 130s, like even throughout college, I was still in the 130s. So then when I seen 179, 180, obviously when you're on your menstrual cycle, you can gain between 3 to 5 pounds of bloat and all that. I normally gain about 3 to 5 pounds, and obviously during that 179, 180 day I seen, that was when I was on my cycle. When I went off of my cycle, I was back to like 175, 176. But the problem is, I had never been that big, so I'm not comfortable with it. And even though I was making small strides to make changes, I still wasn't really noticing a significant difference. And then I started to realize, like, bro, you don't even sleep enough. You're not sleeping enough. You're not drinking your gallon of water. You're not doing the things that, you know, promote the healthiness. It's an overall picture when you're trying to get your body a certain way. It's an overall thing that you should be doing. Sleep is one of them. If you're lacking sleep, that can mess up with your insulin levels and your cortisol levels, your, you know, resistance and stuff like that. And then you got to think about certain foods you're eating and what they're doing to your body and paying attention to that. Because just because it's vegan friendly does not mean it's you friendly. So you have to figure out, what is it that I'm supposed to eat? Observation, just to throw this in, whenever I eat soy products, vegans do eat soy. When I eat soy products, if I have, let's say some veggie sausage to go in my vegan boil, the next day, you can count on me being about 2 to 3 pounds heavier. And I could take my probiotics, and sometimes I'm, you know, 1 or 2 pounds up, but a lot of times I'm about 2 to 3 pounds heavier. And I notice when I eat soy that sometimes that's what happens to me, because it's still considered like processed, because you're putting it on this, you're putting it in a frying pan and you're putting oil, whether it be olive avocado, whatever oil you're using, even if it's a healthy oil, it's still kind of taking it out of its natural state for you to kind of process it. So it's still like processed. And whenever I have processed things, I notice sometimes skin breakout. Sometimes I notice like my skin will be more oily than usual. And then when I don't have soy, it's like I feel different. I'm not saying that soy does not do to my body what meat did. Meat made me feel very, very sick. Soy does not make me feel very, very sick. Probably because I don't eat it every day, but it doesn't make me feel sick. And then the makeup of soy products are, okay with me for the most part. But that's what I notice. I'll have like more oily skin, or I'll put on 2 to 3 pounds. So do you think I eat soy every day? No, I don't, because I know what my limits need to be when it comes to soy. So I literally went from the 180 to, I woke up this morning at 164.0. Now, over the last couple of months, you guys have been hearing me do my updates, my weigh-ins, my everything, and I have literally been at those last 160 marks that I can't seem to get over, those plateaus. So the other day, I was back at 166.0, and what did I have? I had soy. And I'm just like, And these are things that you do, you observe within your body, and you figure out what's happening and how do I fix it. So I said, okay, I won't have soy the next day. Like, I'm only gonna have fruits and vegetables. I had a green smoothie yesterday, and I had literally like vegan rice balls, kind of like a sushi inspired thing. So they were rice balls, and I had like this amazing sauce. I didn't have any soy. I only had rice, vegetables, and a green smoothie, which I'm going to have one later today, with the rest of the spinach in the refrigerator. I'm going to make a green smoothie and everything like that. So that's what I had. And your girl turned out fine. She turned out fine. But no, I woke up this morning, I was 2 pounds lighter. I didn't do my workouts yesterday. I didn't go heavy yesterday. I've been literally contemplating. There's a lot of things I have to get done. There's a lot that's been on my mind. There's a lot that I've been dealing with personally. So I've been taking a step back from my workout, going so heavy. But trust me, a step back is not literally a step out, okay? Because a step back for a day or two is not, So I took a step back real quick to get some things in order. But I didn't work out, and I didn't do anything other than I drank my water, and I wake up and I was 164.0. So obviously, I want to get lower. My goal by the end of this month was to drop down by June 1st and be at 159, 158. I'm not saying it's impossible, but I must tell you guys, my cycle is coming, and I gained 3 to 5 pounds. So I'm really not gonna be mad if I didn't lose the weight. But if I lose it, awesome. If I don't, it's all, within time. I'm not gonna rush the process, because I understand that the process is the process, and you can't rush it. It's gonna go in the way it's going to go. But the goal weight, that's current weight, 164.0, the goal weight is 125, 130 with gains and everything. If I can be in the 120 range, 128, 129, that's fine too. But 125 to 130 is definitely gonna be the target area of growth. Or weight loss, and then I will maintain my muscle status at that weight. But I really don't want to go over the 120s and 130s. But yeah, so that's what I've been doing. Also, if you really want to watch your weight and your muscle growth, and you really, really want to try to get that stomach debloated, because I have noticed a difference in my stomach. My stomach had looked like I was 9 months pregnant before, and now it looks like I'm probably six, maybe five. So I do see the decrease. I know it's not good, but I see the decrease in the stomach, and I'm super proud of my progress. And the bad habits that you have within your lifestyle, sometimes you can't cold turkey them out. Sometimes you just want a moderation. So like when I get stressed, I drink Coca-Cola. Not good, but there was one point where I barely was eating. I was actually just drinking soda at one point, not recent, but like a few years back. And now it's like I get stressed, I'll have a Coke, maybe two at max in a day or so. But it's here and there. I don't keep it in my house. I actually have to go get it, because it's not healthy habits. So I don't keep healthy, non-healthy habits in my house. So I have to go get the Coke. And I have one over there. I went to get food, and the food that I actually bought was disgusting. Like, I think the restaurant was in a rush because, like, traffic is picking back up. And I definitely feel like that contributed to my food seeming undercooked and I didn't eat it. So that's that. And I didn't have time to turn around because the line was so wrapped and they didn't want anybody to come in. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna bite the bullet today. I did get a refund on my drink though, but that was before I tested the food. Because I came there and I wanted a specific drink. How are you gonna run out of the drink that I want? She's like, well, we have other. I don't want others. Can I get that refund on that drink? But yeah, so that's what I'm doing. Make sure you guys share with me what you guys are doing. I would love to know what's going on. Just keep each other accountable and check in here and there. But I want you guys to go ahead, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe. And I do want to say thank you guys for allowing me to hit 200 followers, 200 subscribers. All 200 of you matter. Thank you so much for making these 200 followers special. I am very humbled by it. I know that people think, well, you shouldn't say thank you for 200 subscribers. Say it when you got 2 million. But I believe in small steps. I believe in being humble, and I believe in humble beginnings. There's one day that I'm gonna look back on my channel, and I'm gonna be way past 200 subscribers, and I'm gonna look back and say, geez, I remember when I said I'm gonna look back. So I thank you guys for tuning in constantly, giving opinions, just liking my videos and feedback and all of that. I've had some people reach out to me, and I definitely look at this as another platform to make a difference, to impact, to inspire. I told you guys I had my channel for years now. Literally made this channel, I think, back in 2016 or 15, and still have it. Wasn't on there as much. Got on there, deleted videos when I didn't feel like the content was good enough, and blase, blase. But over the last year, I've been more dedicated to the channel, and I'm seeing the growth from it. I'm seeing your responses back from it, and I know that I'm doing the right thing by having my channel. So make sure you guys like, comment, share, subscribe. If you want to catch up with my regular life, then go to Kralisa Victoria on Instagram. I am also in real estate, so if you're looking to buy, sell, or invest or anything like that, no matter what state you're in, just go ahead and give me a holler at Kralisa Victoria. I do have a page that's also dedicated to real estate, so just go to my main page to follow everything. If you want to hear about locks, like my hair, then go follow our page, Babe with Locks. If you want to shop Kralisa Victoria, shop that. If you want lipsticks and all that, go to Kralisa Victoria Collection. There's a lot that's going to be dropping. There's a lot of revamping, a lot of things that I'm going to be doing for my business, and I hope that you guys are going to be sticking around to see those changes and be a part of the change. So I will see you beautiful people in the next video. Thanks for tuning in. Bye.
It's only 11 something, but why does it feel like it's 2 something?